Now let's talk about XPath node expressions. So what is node? Everything which you see, node is kind of a tag. Okay, so we wrote this, right? This is HTML is one node, body is one node, div is one node, header is one node, again div is one node. So all these are considered nodes. Okay, so node expressions are those to find out. So when you write, when we write slash slash in this web page, we found out all the nodes available in this web page. We can see there are 157 nodes available in this web page. So if you see this slash slash, what it does is basically selects node in the document from the current node that matches the selection, no matter where they are. Okay. So since I do not have any filtering yet, it is giving me everything regarding this, every node present in this web page. Okay, now let's see. It says select from the root node. If I do something like this, so now it has increased. Sorry. Now you can see I have a div. Let's say when I do div, I can see we have 261 div. But when I do div slash div, okay, I can see less div. When I do slash div, I can see again less div. So slash is basically gives you the selects from the root node. So it selects all the things from the root node. Root means your ancestor node, which is the ancestor node. So generally, we add something here. So let's say I will say this div, this whole div is this, which is this page. I will talk about ID. These are attributes. When I say div, you can see there is one div under that, lot of only this div is available. But when I do slash slash div after that, okay, I can see there are two divs which are available under this page div. Okay, so it's so single double slash will find out all the nodes from the document, and single slash will find out all the nodes which is present under the master div. Dot selects the current. So similarly, I do something like this. For this element, I do contains instead of text. So see, we were using text last time. Instead of text, instead of text, I use something like dot. So see, still it is working. So you can have anything here. Like there are multiple attributes. There could be multiple attributes for this. Not this. Let's take some other element. Let's say this div. So you can see this div, this li has class. Okay, this li has ID. Okay, and it could have some text also later on. So when we want multiple options, like so we don't want to say find me all the anchor tag where text is equal to div. We can say find me all the anchor tags regardless of text or class name or name or ID where the content is login. Okay, so this is where you can use dot, and it works on a current node only. So it works only on this particular node only which we are selecting. Dot dot selects the parent of current node. Now dot dot, if you work in Linux, when you do cd dot dot, you go back to the parent or go back to the previous state. Similarly here, if I do this, okay, you go back to the parent. Okay, in this case, because A is there, it will not work. But I could say okay, something like this. So it will give me all the link. So this is different from this. So when I'm doing slash slash a, it is giving me 47. But when I'm doing this, it is giving me 44. Okay. So with dot dot, you can get the parent of the current node. At the rate, it is pretty simple. When you need to find out anything, so this li has id, this li has class, so if you need to select any particular attribute of this particular element, you can use at the rate. So here I could say id is equal to this, one of the way you don't lose the view is basically if you add it as in HTML. Add it as in HTML. So with this, even if you don't write anything, you will not lose the view. So I could say id is equal to this and find out the element. Okay. So anything, any attribute, if you write, you need to write XPath based on any attribute, you use at the rate. Okay, select attributes. Now creating your XPath, first XPath. We already seen the examples of this, collecting this. So let's say we have to write a automation test case. The test case is on test auto Masi. You need to click on login link, then type username, then type password on login page, and then click on login button. And after logging in on dashboard page, you need to verify that the username is present in the bold letters and username is correct. Okay. Without doing any coding, first of all, we need to find out all the XPath, capture it, collect it, and then finally we will write the test scripts later on. So we already got the first one, right? The first one was slash a contains text. Login, right? You can save it in some notepad. So using Selenium method, like click, you click on this XPath and come on this profile page, which is a login page also. Why it is taking much time? Okay. Once you are there, select this, find out the XPath of this is basically, now see there are a lot of attributes here. This is an input field and it has attribute size, placeholder, tag, type, ID, class, name. Okay. So I can write XPath input at the rate id equal to username. Right. Input at the rate input at the rate id equal to username. And if it is not coming as unique, right now it is coming as unique because I have multiple option, I can use AND operator also. And let's say placeholder, problem with this, if I make some grammatical error, if I make some mistake, Chrome will just show me 0 out of 0. It would not show me what is the error, what is the exact mistake I'm making. So here, instead of equal, I can say contains, right? Contains at the rate placeholder is equal to contain right. Am I making some mistake? Contains is not necessary.
Remove that equal. When you are using contains, use comma in place of equal.
Fine. I took the exact word. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
It contains was not necessary because I took the exact same. So this is how you create XPath. You make mistake and you don't know which mistake I'm making. Right, and you have to play around and then find out, yeah, this was the mistake, right? So I found out the XPath of this. I can use now. Similarly, the XPath for password would be, now I shown you the example of and. I can directly use password. Okay, again, one of one. And then I need to get the XPath of login button. Here, only thing I have is type is equal to submit. Let's see if it is the unique one. Button at the rate type is equal to submit. Okay, I think this gives me two XPath, not the unique one. Right. Now, if I visit this again. I will use text because submit is not the unique one. So contains text is equal to login. Okay. And finally, once I got the XPath, I will enter all these details and log in. So we will go in detail about each function later on. We have a section, separate section for operators, functions. It's just that we are right now trying to show you how do you create your first XPath and without having all those knowledges of better function or better operators. So now my motto is to verify this username. The problem with this is this will be different for different users. So for this user, this is full stack demo. But for different users, it will depend on the username which user typed on the login page. So this would be a customized thing. So generally, what is the XPath of this? I can just copy and see. This is the XPath of this. ID is equal to this, /strong, right? This is the XPath given by Chrome to me. Now with this approach, again, there is a dependency on absolute one, whether if we have another div between this PPP or a div, it becomes an issue. So what I can do, I can simply say in here, we can use following. Okay, following strong. Okay. So now we have removed the dependency of /div/p. Any strong keyword which is coming on under this particular section, which is this section, is basically our username, right? So we created this also and we are saving it. So that is how you create a login test case, create XPath for the login test case using Chrome DevTools. Now there is a better way to do it and quicker way to do it using selector sub. and I give the control to Sanjay to show us how can we do it faster and efficiently using Circle.
Thank you, Chandan. It was great learning, and you explained very well. I got many ideas meanwhile, and like many things which I can improve in like in Selector through this session. So definitely I will be doing that. Okay. So like we have seen here when we were typing, when Chandan was typing, okay, before that, I just want to make sure, like, am I audible, Chandan?
Yes, I am.
Like, perfect. Okay. And now my screen is also visible. So here, like Chandan was, when Chandan was writing here the selector, so let's say for this element. Okay, so very first thing, let me just zoom in. Very first thing, let me tell you guys that when you type here something, like in DevTools, like /A, this is not just verifying the XPath, or this is not just giving you the XPath. This works like search functionality on a page. So it wherever it will find /A, that count also it will give. So this 1 of 28 is not all the A tag, all the A node in this DOM. It is also counting this /A here, like this. This is not an anchor tag. You see, this is a link tag while it is finding for this one. So the DevTools first of all is not an only XPath solution. You will get a lot of wrong information with which you might get confused, and you can give like wrong information to someone. Like, let's say somebody in interview asks you like how many links on this page, and you just did /A and you told like 28, but no, this is wrong. Here it is not an anchor tag. It is finding this match because /A is there. So, and apart from this, you have seen, like we have seen when Chandan was giving the demo, he was like, if we have to copy some value from here, we have to like here either like double click on this and or like right click and then edit as HTML, and then you copy this value, right? Because we cannot remember this value, or while typing as well, like /input. As soon as you start typing here, the DOM used to scroll up and down. You see, like let's say if we have to write it for password, okay? And when you will type here /input, this goes up and it is highlighting this one while we have to write. Sometime even it used to go like this as well when we are typing. And every time it used to go up and down. So there is like a lot of challenges. Like we have to copy the value, we have to inspect again and again, we are losing the view. Apart from that, it is giving the wrong information as well. Like when you will type something, it will search. It works like search, as well as it verifies XPath in CSS Selector. We can verify in DevTools. So solving all these problems, here we have the like, because we are in 2020 in the era of COVID, where we have like smart IntelliJ like Sublime, Eclipse, IntelliJ is there. So for writing code and all, we have so many smart editor, but for XPath still we are copying these values and we are writing like XPath manually. Why so? So here it is something like new innovation which made it possible to write own XPath in CSS Selector in less than 3-4 seconds without compromising his learning skills. Yeah. And a lot more learning is there. So very first thing, how to install Selector Sub. Let me just show it quickly. OpenSelectorSub.com. Here it is available for all the browsers, Chrome, Firefox, Edge, Opera. So let me give a demo quickly on Chrome. So you can add it here. It's very simple. This is how you can add. There's no dependency on any other browser or anything or any other plugin. So we have installed it. Once you install it, just restart your browser. It is always recommended restart or refresh the page which you have already opened. Now just right click here. After adding it, you will not find it here in Chrome, latest Chrome. So you have to like pin to toolbar. Click on this extension, pin to toolbar. Selector sub icon will be here and basic information will be here. Now where to find in DevTools, right click here, whichever element you want to inspect, And then you see here on the left side, DOM is there. On the right side, there will be sidebar. This we used to call sidebar. So here it will be the last tab. Open select user, or you just expand it for the better view, better, like you will always find. So see, now you see the magic here. As soon as you start typing here, double forward slash, you got the auto suggest like we got in our smart editor, like a smart IntelliJ we used to get, right? When we type, we got the phone sense, etc. So here you got, and as well as you got the information, like there are 14 input here itself. So now you need not to type complete thing. You need not to hit enter, press enter, check out like how many input texts are there. Everything it is telling here only. And this is for what you are writing. You are typing XPath. So it is giving you that this is an XPath suggestion. Select this one. Now you just type open bracket and you see the magic. You need not to select, copy or type complete thing. You see everything you got it along with their occurrences. So it is telling you that if you use this @ID function with attribute, this, all these are one matching node, while these are like more than one matching node. And if there will be zero, that also it will suggest you for learning perspective. So you see just in single click and you hit enter, you here you go. And if you have to add like and condition as well, like here you have to and @ some other conditions as well, so that you can add, like Chandan was showing you guys. So this is like really amazing. You see how much less time it will take you to write any XPath for yourself. No need to copy value from the dev tools. No need to like right click, edit, or wasting time. Suppose you have to find out like how many anchor links on this page. You just hear /A and hit enter. There are 21 links. From here you got to know, and all will be highlighted here. All the links will be here. You see, these are all A tags. These are the anchor tags which are the here. If you do same thing, DevTools /A, there are 28 it is showing, which is wrong, absolutely wrong, because it is link also it is showing. This link tag is also it is showing as an anchor tag, which is wrong. It is finding the /A. So a lot of good things here and saves a lot more time. It gives you like, if you make any mistake while writing our XPath here, you see, so we are writing for this one. Let's say we are writing /input and here you type something. And by mistake, you like you have added this one, or let's say you missed a square bracket. If you press enter, it will tell you that you missed a square bracket. If you same thing you will be doing here in dev tools, it will not tell you anything. It will just say 0 of 0. You'll be wasting time. Okay, like what I missed it here, what is wrong here. So that all things, it will help a lot. Like dev selectors will help you to learn those things. If anything like single code got missed, you see, it will immediately highlight and tell you that you are doing something wrong here. Like anything you will be missing, that it will highlight here. It is going to save a lot more time. In fact, like you can write, though this is an XPath workshop, I can also, like it also helps you to write your own CSS selector. Let's say like here, ID is there. You just type # It will give you the CSS selector with ID. Like you can also type in this format. And you see all the functions it used to give for the CSS, and it suggests that it is for CSS selector, and you hit enter. So it is helps a lot, saves a lot more time with a lot more functions. Anything you can get it here. Like from here, we think like /// or dot, everything it gives here. And it also gives the like following siblings, etc. Like let's say you have typed something like this. Now you want the ancestor, descendants, parent, child, and you don't know about them, like what is ancestor for this element, what are the following siblings, etc. for this element. So you just type here ancestor, A-N. It will give all the ancestor for this current inspected element, and it will give the auto suggest for the inspected element, current inspected element with respect to current. Like right now it will give all the suggestion with respect to this input. If you want for this div, then you will have to inspect this one. Okay. Like if you want following siblings, so if there will be following siblings, it will show following siblings. If there are preceding, then preceding. Because preceding is not there, then it's not. So let me take an example which will have everything. So this div has preceding siblings. So if you type your div, and then if you type like preceding, it will show preceding sibling because there is a div. This is a preceding sibling. So that it will give. If you type here following, it will be following. So there are following sibling input and div for this one. Input and div. So it is showing that. So likewise, if it helps a lot and saves a lot more time. So this way you can write for this one. So ancestor, descendants, everything it supports. And there are a lot more features which I will show you in the upcoming slide. So you can save a lot more time. You can learn from here. If anything is missing in your selectors, that can also help you a lot. Okay, over to you, Chandan.
Thanks, Sanjay. Okay. In the meantime, I was also testing out. So, if you have any questions till now, you can ask guys in the chat. Okay. We have to go ahead and next part functions. Okay. No questions? Type 2 if you have no questions. Beans is very quiet. I think only Samir is active.
Yeah, is crop path going to be deprecated? Yes, so I won't say, I won't give any comment on that. Definitely, I'm not working on crop path now, and there is no update on that. So, and selector sub is the new reality, and I'm working on selector sub full time. And it is going to be more than, I mean, definitely it is 100 times more powerful than my previous innovation. And very soon, like I'm working on 2.0, selector sub 2.0, which is taking shape now. And it is going to really, really powerful. But yeah, crop path, like in different browser, it is not updated and it's not like, I left crop path on 18th of June. It was not a like, easy decision, so we'll not go in that detail, but yeah, I'm not working on ProPath anymore. Selector sub is the new reality, and you will it will support on all the browser with same functionality. Double forward says is for path, what about CSS? So okay, so double forward slash is like for traversing like one after the other, or like directly from top HTML document to like any element, whichever tag name you will add. So that is double forward slash. About CSS, so first of all, start calling it CSS selector. This is not CSS. CSS is something like cascading style sheet, like which colors and everything styling on your website. It is CSS selector. So CSS selector is formula for CSS selector. If you want to write it with class, then you have to start with dot and replace all the space with dot. For if you want to write CSS selector with ID, then you have to write hashtag and ID value. If you want to write in like that way, tag name and attribute value, then you start with tag name, then attribute, then open square bracket, then attribute is equal to attribute value. Close square bracket. So that is a formula for that. And if you just start typing on selector sub, you will be able to understand. I hope Sankal that helps. One suggestion: add by.xpath, by.id, etc. in selector sub. It will save more time. Sure. Thank you for suggestion, and definitely you will get this feature in next release. Is it available anywhere in the documentation on the selector sub? Yes, all the documentation is available here. Like in selector sub, if you open selector sub tab there, in the footer, there are like a lot of links. Okay, let me share my screen. So in the footer, this is for other screen sharing. Sorry, Chandan, I'm just for a second, I'm taking this.
Yeah, sure.
So here, if you see in the footer, there are like a lot of links are here. So really important links. So here you click on that information icon. Okay, this one, learn more about XPath and CSS selector functions. So here I'm like keep adding more functions and errors, everything. So you will learn more about them from here. So this you can explore. Please explore here. So you will get, I will add more functions here. And do check out the videos, tutorial videos. So here you can find the video tutorials. So that also you can check it out. So yeah, everything is here. So video tutorials are as well here, so that you can explore. And all the documentation and everything, blogs, everything is here. You just need to like check it out once. I would recommend that just check out this video, tutorial video, you will get to know everything. And Selector Sub itself is self-explanatory for everything. You're most welcome, Sankal. And if you have any doubt, you can reach out to me, Chandan, anytime, anywhere, in any of the social media. It's my pleasure, Conrad. Thank you. Chandan, we can proceed now, I guess. We will keep taking your guys' questions, keep shooting your question as much as possible.
Cool. Okay. Yeah, so by.xpath, I agree, by.xpath and ID, but don't add driver dot, okay? Because no one uses driver dot find element dot like used in TruePath.
Yes, definitely. Yeah, definitely, Chandan. Yes. Actually, that is the default one. Anybody can add it there. Yeah, but definitely will not add because I know now nobody is using driver dot find element. Dot. That helps sometimes in interview or just like for the beginners when they start learning.
But the dangerous part is people actually think that this is how you write script. People use by to store locators or they use strings, okay, to store locators. Anyone will work.